Hey YouTube, Hambone here, F1 Manager 22, Aston Martin career, with our new drivers Oscar Piastri and Fernando Alonso. Alonso replaced Lance Stroll, because Stroll was just, I don't know, he was as bad as Latifi. Even though he was supposed to be a better driver, I really think if I had Latifi on the team, he would have done just as good a job as Stroll. And Seb decided not to re-sign. He told us to go to hell. So he's not going to renew his contract. Even though we offered him $17 million for one season, $1.5 million lump sum, and $1.5 million bonus for a top 10 finish. He told us to go to hell. So we brought in Piastri to replace him. And we're about to head out to Bahrain for our second season, number two, race number one, practice and qualifying. So let's head on out. Get practice and qualifying over with. I'm excited about the point system. Welcome. The point system is going to really change this season. Because we have points. The top eight are only ones going to be getting points. We pretty much have the sprint race point system. So, and with the sprint race point system, it's going to be hard to get a huge lead if you keep alternating wins. So all right, let's head out for practice.
Radio check.
Okay,
it's green now.
And here we go. Both drivers out for the first practice run of the 2023 season. Season number two, Aston Martin career. And we're going after the championship, constructors and drivers championship. We are either the second or third best team. I think Ferrari is the best. We are very close to Red Bull for second place, so. There we go. And then we about completed our first practice run.
What's your thoughts on coming in or 90. Doing any more?
Okay. Alonso 89, Piastri. No. Alonso 90, Piastri 89. Well, That may do it. There's a chance. hell with it, we'll give it a shot. 33 laps, so let's go 25 for now.
How does it feel?
Yeah, fingers good, guys.
Are you firm?
You know, 5-5 with him also. Yeah, with it, we'll try the same thing, yeah, with it. Come on, Fernando. I'm gonna get you your third driver's championship. Get Fernando his third driver's championship, get Aston Martin their first constructor's title. Come on, boys. Finish up the second round here. Come on. We're almost complete our second one now.
That sounds like someone's gone wide there.
Schumacher runs wide. Come on already. Oh, went down, damn it. I went down for Piastri, but not much.
How's the balance?
Both of them, god dang it.
We're good. Happy.
The wrong way with both of them.
Okay, pit lane. Copy that.
that a lockup?
Radio check?
Yeah, radio check.
Green light, green light. Let's take a closer look. So this was the Aston Martin. They've locked up and gone straight on. We can take a look now. Let's have a look here. This was the Aston Martin. It's a lockup, and that.
both drivers now at 100%. We're going to get to see how
what
many laps each driver can do on these hard set of tires.
Well done, guys. Very good. Copy.
Copy.
We'll have an idea how many laps Piastri can do on the hard tires. That's what I'm really excited about. So, because his tire wear ability is not very good, but it doesn't look like he's doing too bad compared to Fernando Alonso. Alonso's 40 points better than him, so looks like Alonso might get a couple lap, two laps. Maybe three more laps at most. I think they've done the same amount of laps right now. Alonso's done one more. Okay, 23, 22. There's 23. So both drivers have done 23 at the moment, and Piastri's only 4% less. I think the soft or medium tires, that's what will be noticeable. What is that? That's 25 laps for Piastri. That's about all he can do. Alonso might get 28 out of them.
Let's have a look here. This was the Aston Martin. Goodness me! They're
Copy.
So what do you want, Joe? What do you want, box?
Wow. Both drivers made it. Made it to 30 laps.
Safe fuel.
Copy.
Drop back a bit.
Copy.
Yeah, take it easy.
Okay. Energy's good.
Copy.
Up low batteries.
And that will do it for our practice session. Lonzo third, Piastri fifth. Hell yeah. Both drivers in great shape. Let's head out for first round of qualifying.
Radio check.
Lance and Piastri first.
Radio check,
Lonzo
okay.
Behind
radio
him.
Check.
Well,
it
easily
should be green
now. Second round of qualifying. Easily. To the second separates Alonso and Piastri. I'm curious to see where Mercedes qualifies at, because their car was pretty trash coming into this race. I mean, they were outside the top 10 and everything. Russell somehow got up to sixth. Hamilton down in 19th. Wow. And Hamilton does make it. Somehow Valtteri goes faster than us. I don't know how, considering our car is a lot better than his. What's Alonso got on his soft tires? 87%. Soft, medium, soft strategy. Although Piastri would probably be, he'll probably be on the soft, hard, medium strategy.
I think it's okay.
If we can make it to the third round of qualifying with this set of tires, Alonso should be able to do the soft, medium, soft strategy. At least 500 to a second faster. Faster than Valtteri this time. Valtteri must have had use of DRS on somebody. Hamilton, Russell, struggling. Hamilton outside the top 10 right now. He may not make it. Do I need to? Half a second? I don't think so. I think we're clear. I think we are clean in the Q3. Yep, on to Q3 with, hell yeah, that's what I needed. Hamilton makes it, George Russell misses it. Both Alpine cars are out. Stroll, Lance Stroll, see? He's in a better car than Vettel, Ricciardo, Zhou Guanyu. And he still cannot fucking get ahead of them. Alpine is the fifth, they might be the fourth best team. Fourth or fifth, they're up there. They're probably the top end of the midfield teams. And he didn't even make it to Q2. Kevin Magnussen makes it to Q3. Wow. Lando didn't make it out of Q1. What happened to Lando? Valtteri goes a little bit faster again. The Ferrari and Red Bull cars are just a little bit faster than us.
Check.
Yeah, play the check. Green light, green light.
I'm almost tempted to put Alonso on this set of tires and let Piastri follow him. That way Piastri gets the DRS off of it. So you came out in front of your teammate, dumbass. I need you behind him.
No saving required.
Copy.
Pick up the pace a bit.
Copy.
I'm going to send Piastri up first and have Alonso kind of follow him. We're going to actually wait till the end. Send him out last. What do I need right there? That's the way we need it. I gotta get Piastri closer to, is it Leclerc or Sainz? It's Leclerc.
We think we can lean on the tyres more.
Copy.
Oh, shit, I probably put both of them.
We need to charge Aeris.
Copy.
Alonso goes fifth. Piastri goes seventh. Okay. So Alonso does. The only cars behind him were the Ferrari and Red Bulls. And that will do it. Perez gets the pole for the first race. Leclerc is second. Verstappen third. Carlos Sainz fourth. It's okay,
the
Bubba.
The grid is packed, and there's electricity
it's okay,
in the
Bubba.
Air.
It's okay.
But there's no surprises
yeah,
in that.
My son's upset.
It's race day.
There was some good work from Aston Martin during the qualifying session, and they will go to the grid full of confidence. We saw a reasonable
sleepy.
Push from Mercedes in qualifying, and they'll have plenty of opportunities here to achieve a great result. And the sky is looking grey and cloudy today. An effective tyre strategy could prove very valuable as the race plays out.
But which team has perfected the strategy that will see them prevail today, here at the Bahrain Grand Prix?
Thank you. sometimes don't know if Piastri can actually make it on the tires. That way, since he's got two, oh, he doesn't have two sets of soft, does he? No, he doesn't. He only has one. Yeah, I'm gonna put him on a soft, medium, medium strategy. It's only 1 second slower. You know, it's almost worth it to do that for Alonso. Yeah, it is almost worth it to do that for Fernando. We'll put both of them in the same strategy to start with. But if Alonso's doing good enough, we may put him on the soft, medium, soft strategy. But if I think he can steal this win or podium by going to the mediums, because everybody wears their tires out. Everyone's tires get completely worn out by the end of the race. So, if we put Alonso on the medium strategy, the soft, medium, medium, he'll have tire left over toward the end of the race so he can push. And he'll be able to blow by these sons of bitches really fast. That's kind of why I thought about doing the soft, hard, medium strategy for Piastri. Because he'll have plenty of tire left over toward the end too, but he may be able to make it. And if not, oh well. Do I really want to take a chance and waste some money, lose money right away? No. No. Because we need all the money we can get right now. We're $1 million in the hole. I'd like to thank y'all for watching. Like, share, subscribe. Comment on the video. Click that bell for notification. That way you get notified every time I upload a video. When I come back, it will be the first race of the 2023 season. Season number 2 of the Aston Martin career. Hopefully, the start of a Constructors' Championship and third championship for Fernando Alonso. I'll see you very soon for the Bahrain Grand Prix.